Hello friends, welcome back. In this video we will see the unboxing and full in-depth review of Redmi 3S Prime. I've been using this device for more than 50 days now. So in this video, before getting into the review, we'll show you the unboxing and what are the things that came in the box, and I will also show you the gaming performance with camera review as well as pros and cons of the smartphone. So without any further ado, so let's unbox the device and see what's inside. So inside the box, you will find the smartphone itself. It's at the top. The initial impression was really good. It just feels like a Redmi Note 3 smaller version. Apart from that, you will also get booklets as well as SIM ejector pin. With that, you will be getting micro USB to USB data cable and wall dock adapter, which has an output of 5V to 2A. Since it has a better battery of 4100mAh, it takes approximately 2.5 hours to charge. So let's check out the specification and in-depth overview of the smartphone. It is running with 1.4 GHz Snapdragon 430 octa-core processor, 3GB DDR3 RAM with 32GB inbuilt storage. It has 5-inch HD display, hybrid SIM card support, and it has 4G and VoLTE support. It has a 13MP rear-facing camera with single LED flash and supports PDAF. At the front, it has 5MP front-facing camera. It supports OTG as well as VR. It has a huge 4100mAh battery and it is selling for the price tag of 9,000 rupees. Setting up the fingerprint was really easy and it is quite accurate. So let's check out the overview of the smartphone. At the back, it has a 13MP rear-facing camera with single LED flash, fingerprint sensor and speakers. Coming on to the right-hand side, you have the volume rocker key as well as power on and off button. The buttons gives very nice tactile feedback. Coming on to the bottom, you have the micro USB port as well as primary microphone. Coming on to the left-hand side, you just have the SIM card tray. On the top, you have the 3.5mm jack, IR blaster as well as secondary noise cancellation mic. All the sides are made up of metal. Coming onto the front, the glass panel covers the entire face of the smartphone, including the display and capacitive keys. And it has a 5MP front-facing camera and the touch capacitive keys are not backlit. A raised chrome lining surrounds the front, which should help in reducing the damage when the smartphone kept and facing downside. So it is running on 900 Marshmallow and the touch capacitive keys are not backlit as said earlier. Sharpness and colors are appealing and even the viewing angles is quite good in outdoor condition. The display impressed us because of the brightness and the sunrise legibility also looks a lot better even in direct sunlight. Coming on to the performance, it scored approximately 650 on single core and with multi-core it scored approximately 2700. Surprisingly, it handles all the heavy games without any lags. Resource hogging games like Asphalt 8 and Dead Trigger 2 push the SoC to its limits and minor frame drops are noticeable. On day-to-day usage, you won't feel any lags with this smartphone because it has a 3GB RAM with a powerful Snapdragon 430 chipset. Considering it has an octa-core processor, you won't feel much of a heating issue while playing games. Performance-wise, it gives you the best result possible. So let's check out the camera review of the smartphone. So it has 13MP rear-facing camera with PDAF. At this price point, we cannot expect superior image quality, but the camera gets the basic things right. Image taken when outdoor condition looks extremely good. So let's check out some of the sample images that I have taken with the smartphone. Under bright and well-lit condition, the image quality seems really good. Even the color contrast ratio also performing really well. The bokeh effect also really nice. But it's not the same when you come out to the indoor condition. So this shot was taken in the rear-facing camera with using LED flash. And you can see the color and contrast ratio seems okay, but the autofocusing seems to be having some issues. So these were some of the shots that I've taken in the front-facing camera. The outdoor condition shots are really good, but it tends to change drastically in indoor condition. So I won't suggest this smartphone if you are looking for a best indoor selfie shots. Let's have a look at the design of the smartphone. When it is compared with Redmi Note 3, as you can see, both looks exactly similar except from the size of 5.5 inch in the Redmi Note 3. This Redmi 3S Prime has only 5 inch display. So apart from that, all the other aspects are pretty much the same. This is the exact portable version of Redmi Note 3, which I liked very much because of its portable size. In and fill of the smartphone is also really good. So let's check out some of the other aspects of the smartphone. Let's check out the camera sample of both the smartphones. As you can see, Redmi Note 3 has better camera when you compare it with Redmi 3S Prime. If you want to see more comparison of these two smartphones, do let me know in the comment section below. I will do that video next. Since it has 4100mAh battery and it supports fast charging, it takes approximately 2 hours to 2.5 hours to charge from 0 to 100. It gives me around 5.5 hours of screen on time. So it is pretty good when you compare with the other smartphones at this price tag. It is pretty impressive. I still believe battery life could be improved by giving some small update. It has IR blaster, which no other smartphone under this price tag has ever offered you, and it has got a full metal body finishing, and it supports OTG as well as it gives you full compatibility with all the VR headsets possible. Should you buy this smartphone? Why not? It has excellent build quality, great design and better display, and the camera quality could have been better, but it's more than average at this price tag. And it is very portable and it's convenient to use in one hand because of its 5-inch display, and you are also getting the full VR support with this smartphone. There are also some noticeable bugs in the smartphone which can be fixed with a minor update. So overall, to the price to performance ratio, this could be the best smartphone you can buy with a display size of 5-inch and under the price tag of 10,000 rupees. So I will rate it 9 out of 10. So if you are planning to buy one, I will leave the direct link in the description. So do use that link if you are planning to buy one. If you want to see more videos of this smartphone, or if you want me to compare this smartphone with any other smartphone, do let me know in the comment section below. Do also check my other videos like comparisons and camera reviews. I will be coming up with more awesome tech videos like this. So if you haven't subscribed to the channel, do subscribe to the channel and hit the like button if you like this video. Hope to see you in my next video. This is Thames signing off.